Hello everyone, today I am going to introduce a very useful video model. Why do I say it is so useful? Because this model can generate high quality video footage with transparency. Let's take a look at the results. Using this model, I can very easily generate a video. And this video comes with an alpha channel, which is what we refer to as the transparency channel. Now pay close attention because this channel is very special. It is not like the channels you get from cutout tools, like the segment anything extension, which are typically just solid white or solid black. This channel actually contains a lot of fine detail. As you can probably see, we can use this channel to place the characters from the video onto any background, achieving what is known as a transparent footage effect. As you can see, the blending result is fantastic. The foreground and background merge together perfectly, but of course, that is not even the main point. If it were just about this, our segment anything tool could also achieve it. The key thing to note is that this model can preserve the transparent properties of objects. So, what does that mean? Look closely at this video I've generated here. It is a beautiful woman drinking juice. The glass she is holding is, of course, transparent. In the generated footage itself, you can't see anything special at first glance, but if you look at its alpha channel, you can see that the glass has transparency properties. So, when we take this video and place it onto our background, you'll find that the background is perfectly visible through the transparent glass. This is what makes this model truly amazing. This model is called Wan Alpha. It is actually a fine-tuned version of the Wan 2.1 model. It retains the ability of Wan 2.1 to generate very high-quality video, while adding the capability to produce transparent videos. If you are interested, you can visit their official website to see more examples. And the foreground isn't just limited to the main subject. In some cases, parts of the background can also be included. For instance, in this example, besides the bird, the tree branch is also fully rendered as part of the foreground. This information is completely captured in our alpha channel. What gets included depends entirely on how we write our prompts. This brings me to an important point. In all your prompts, you must include the word transparent. Whether you are specifying the video should be transparent or the background should be transparent, you have to state it clearly in the prompt. The creators have also been very thoughtful and provided a version for CompUI. You can open the Wan Alpha GitHub page and scroll down to find a dedicated section with instructions for using it in CompUI. This includes the download links for the models. The base model is Wan 2.1, as we've already mentioned. The fine-tuning is implemented as a LoRA, so you'll need to download this LoRA file. Please note, the name of the LoRA might not be finalized yet. The model also supports an acceleration model, so you can use LightX 2 volts. Then, you'll need to download the encoder and the VAE. Note that there are two VAAs, one for RGB and one for the alpha channel, which is a key difference. Once you've downloaded everything, just place the models into their corresponding folders according to the directory structure provided. You can download the example CompUI workflow from the link on their page. To make this demonstration easier, I've also set up the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub AI. Running Hub is an online CompUI workspace I use frequently because they are always the first to integrate new extensions and technologies as soon as they are released. You can use the invitation link in my video description to register for Running Hub and receive 1,000 free credits. You also get 100 bonus credits for logging in daily, which is great for trying out your own workflows. The workflow you see here is one I've slightly restructured to make it easier to see the final results. I have a basic configuration section here where I've set the resolution, width, and height, and the number of frames. I'm using 33 frames here, but you can go up to 81. My resolution is 832 by 480. Next is the model loading section. First, we load the main Wan 2.1 text-to-video model. Then, we load the acceleration model, which is LightX 2 volts. After that, we load the corresponding LoRA, which is the key component for generating transparent videos. Then comes the text encoder. And as I emphasized earlier, there are two VAEs, one RGB VAE and one alpha channel VAE. So you need to load both here. The rest of the setup is basically identical to a standard Wan 2.1 text-to-video workflow. Now, let's write a prompt. I'll keep it simple. A little girl is blowing bubbles. And remember the crucial part specified that the background is transparent. This must be clearly written. After that, the process goes through the sampler. I recommend using 8 sampling steps for best results. But if you are concerned about speed, 4 steps will work because we are using the acceleration LoRA. We set the CFG to 1. Next is the decoding process, which is a bit more complex here. First, we need to decode the RGB content. This gives you a sequence of images. To make it clearer, I am not displaying it as a video here. The second step is decoding the alpha channel, which will give us a sequence of image masks. The main difference between these two decoding paths is that they use different VAS. The developers also created a custom node to display the transparent content. However, I am not sure if it is an issue with the running hub implementation or the node itself, but right now it only shows a single frame instead of a video. So, to show you the result more clearly, I've extended the workflow a bit. I added a background video here, a park scene. Then, using the image composite mask node, which we've used many times before, we can merge the two image sequences together using our mask. An important detail, the output from the alpha decoding is an image, so you first need to convert it into a mask before feeding it into the composite node. After doing that, we can blend our generated character with the background. And notice the bubbles she blows are also transparent. This really shows that the results from this model are fantastic and quite different from traditional cutout methods. Of course, you can test different prompts and backgrounds, for example. Let's change the background and the prompt to "A beautiful woman is dancing." Again, making sure to specify the video is transparent, we get another great blended result. However, after a few tests, I did notice a slight decrease in the aesthetic quality of the human figures. This issue doesn't seem to affect objects. Though, let's look at this example. The background video is an oasis on a snowy mountaintop, shot from a bird's eye view. My prompt is to generate a flying eagle. First, let's look at the generated RGB video. Notice that at the beginning, there is some background pixel information. You can see this in the mask as well, where the background is initially white, but then gradually fades away, leaving the eagle as the main subject. As a result, when we composite it, you'll see clouds and mist at the start, and then the eagle slowly becomes the focus of the scene. The effect is stunning. So, what can you do if the quality of the people isn't perfect? As you might have guessed, since this model supports Wan 2.1 LoRa seamlessly, you can simply add a character beautification LoRa, for instance. In this next example, I've added a LoRA that I previously trained specifically for the Wan 2.1 model. I don't recommend setting the weight to 1. I found 0.75 works well. My prompt is simply "she is dancing," and the background video is a simple scene of a mountain stream. Let's check out the result. To make it easier to see, I've combined everything into videos. This is the original RGB video. The model tries to keep the background a solid color, but as you can see around the hair, there is still some pixel information there. But the mask is incredibly detailed. You can see it contains depth information for the glasses, eyes, and hair. It is not just a flat white mask when composited. The result is a very natural blend. Now for the example I showed you at the very beginning, in that one, I generated some smoke because smoke is transparent. I also added a glass, which is also transparent. We can see that the smoke is present in the foreground information, and in the mask, besides the character details, the transparent quality of both the glass and the smoke is perfectly preserved. Let's look at the final blended result. The white smoke doesn't completely block the background. You can see the transparency is maintained. This effect is even more pronounced on the glass. Since the eyes also have a lot of transparent detail, you'll notice subtle changes in them that correspond to the ambient light. You can even see bits of the background through the gaps in her hair. So, through these examples, you can see that with this technology, we can create incredibly impressive transparent video assets. That is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it out for yourself. Follow me to become an AI expert.